This is a video to help you understand key X, key Y, key Z in GeoShred. I'll focus initially on how it works internally. We don't use MIDI internally. And then I'll show you how it works in the context of MIDI MPE for external MIDI in and MIDI out. So let's start out. I'm going to create a new preset from scratch. I'll just call it U. And we'll just play it. And the very first thing to note is in the X direction, it's quantized. So under performance settings, and this is covered in chapter 4 of our video manual performance settings, you can put it in slide mode. Key X is always mapped to pitch bend. It's pretty much the same thing in MIDI MPE as well. Key X is, or the X direction is mapped to pitch bend. And so I'm gonna put it in slide mode. And you get sliding with magic pitch rounding. Again, this is covered in chapter 4 of our performance settings video, so I won't go very much into that. And now let's take a look here. Let's take a look at how key Y is programmed in GeoShred. And key Z is only available on the iPhone, so I'll switch to an iPhone that has 3D touch for key Z, but let's go ahead and take a look at it for key Y. I'm gonna go to the control surface editor and poly expression. This is how you program key Y behavior. And you can assign key Y to lots of things. There's about 170 parameters in the system. It's very typical to assign it to something like vibrato depth or volume for a swell or filter cutoff. You can also assign it to the controls of effects units in the effects chain, but the issue is with that is that it's not poly, meaning that there's only, say that you assign it to the rate of a flanger, there's only one flanger after the guitar, and so if you have two keys that are trying to change the rate of the flanger with key Y, you'll get some fighting for the value. So let's go ahead and we're just gonna do a simple example first. So I'm just gonna add something here. Under guitar, I'm going to choose one of the polyphonic per string controls that I assigned to key Y. Vibrato depth is very easy to hear, so I'll go ahead and try that one. Very nice. And we can do it polyphonically. Now let's look at a slightly more complex example. Let's do a volume swell, a polyphonic volume swell. And so I'm going to go here under guitar per string, string volume, and I'm going to assign this, we'll do this, close, close, but you're going to see there's some oddness about it. I'll even save it right here. That's not a very good swell. Well, the reason for that is that you have to set up some initial conditions. So there's the inspector for any one of the controls that you can assign to key Y. So its initial value is 10. Well, that's no good. What we need to do is have it start out at 0 because it's going to be a swell. And then when you lift your finger, you need to have it snap back to 0. So that's set value on release. So let's go ahead and try that. Save it. And now a very nice swell. And it's polyphonic. Let's go back and look at the inspector one more time. There's a couple other things to note about the inspector. You'll notice that where I put my finger initially is 0. You can have it be absolute if you want. Few people like to do that. We'll talk about exceptions when we get into key Z assignment. And then you can also have a curve for it if you want. You want to have some crazy volume curve? Let's take a look at how key Z works on an iPhone that supports 3D touch. So let's just create a new preset, and I'll just call it anything. And the first thing that you want to do is you want to, under settings, you want to enable 3D touch. 3D touch is going to give you two things. It's going to give you pressure right off the screen, which gets mapped to key Z. And if it goes out to MIDI MPE, it goes out directly as channel pressure. And the other thing it gives you is when you touch, at the moment of the touch, it computes a velocity as well. So, let's take a look here. Okay, so let's just do the same thing that we did before. We're going to go edit the control surface. And we're going to go here under poly expression. And we're going to go ahead and add something under guitar. I'm going to use vibrato again, per string, vibrato depth. And let's take a look at the inspector. And you'll notice now, because you're on an iPhone, you can see, you can assign velocity, or excuse me, you can assign vibrato depth either to key Y or to key Z. Let's take a look at how velocity works with 3D touch. So you can hit it softly or hard, and you get different velocities. If you take a look here under settings, you can see that 3D touch is actually enabled right now, but for both the velocity and the pressure, there is a curve that you can noodle with. And you can also, you know, you can make it log or exponential. And you can do the same thing for the pressure curve as well. Also, let's take a look at how velocity is handled on an iPad that does not have 3D touch. So there's no way to sense velocity off the screen. So what we and a bunch of other companies do is we use something called Key-Y Touch, which is an analog to 3D touch. So let's take a look at under settings, you can turn on something called Enable Key-Y Touch. And so now the Key-Y position is used to set the initial velocity. And there's also a velocity curve settings, key Y velocity curve right here, which you can noodle with, and I can make it very extreme. You can see that it tracks, or I can make it very subtle. So that's how velocity works on iPads that don't have 3D touch. Now let's take a look at how MIDI is configured. This is preset number 136, Shred MPE Wah. It's got a very nice polyphonic. Polyphonic Wah. And on the iPad, where there is no key Z, the Wah is being done with key Y. However, on the iPhone where there's key Z, the Wah is done with key Z. And there's a single preset that works on both devices. So let's just take a look at how MIDI is configured. There's a little dance that is done in order to make this work. Let's take a look at the Wah. And first off, let's take a look at the MIDI settings. It's sending and receiving MIDI. Note that channel pressure is the MPE key Z or pressure controller. And in MPE brightness, CC74 is the key Y controller. And then for a conventional MIDI controller, the only opportunity you have for expression is the mod wheel. And as far as receiving MIDI is concerned, it's going to respond to either channel pressure, brightness, or mod wheel. And we'll take a look at what that means in the context of an instrument that sends both channel pressure and brightness. There's a little exclusion mechanism. Mod wheel means that a standard MIDI controller can still control this by flipping the mod wheel. And then as far as sending MIDI is concerned, it's only sending channel pressure because it has this switch called send first control. Now let's take a look at the string wah here. This is where I mentioned exceptions earlier. What's going on here is even though it's receiving both channel pressure and brightness number 74, this control, the Y, is only responding to channel pressure or mod wheel. It's not responding to CC74. And that's because on this particular preset, the scraping of the string against the frets is actually coming through CC74. You can see here that the scraping of the fret is going to respond to CC74. Which is the key Y motion on a controller like a Roli Seaboard or an instrument. Let's put it all together. Here's a conventional MIDI controller using the single channel MIDI configuration and the mod wheel for expression. Here's a Roli Seaboard Rise using the Seaboard MIDI configuration. And here's a Linstrument using the Linstrument MPE MIDI configuration.